Hi. This is part 2 of the training video on how to use Rapid STM32 block set with non-FIO evaluation boards. Let's begin by launching KeelReelView MDK forearm. Start a new project by selecting Project, then New Project. Is as easy as to create the project inside the same folder, which contains all the header and source files created by Simulink earlier. By default, this folder is named with the same name as the Simulink model file, and ends with _rapid_stm32. In our case, the required folder is non-FIO_PWM_demo_rapid_stm32. Proceed and save our Keel project as non-FIO_PWM_demo. Next, select our MCU, which, in our case, is STM32F103RE. The next step is very important. When asked to copy the startup code, select NO. This is because we will be using a startup code generated from Simulink. Next, we will add source files to the project by double-clicking Source Group 1. Add all .c files. Then, change the file type to assembly file. That is with .s extension. Look for our startup file that begins with startup_stm32f10x, and ends with .s. Add this file to the project. All the source files for our project are now listed under Source Group 1. Next, click on the Target Options button. On the Target tab, tick Use Microlib. This option generally leads to smaller code size for an executable file. On the Output tab, tick Read Hex File. On the C++ tab, various optimization levels may be used to reduce executable code size, or reduce execution time. However, note that, using optimization level 3, for example, may affect debugging by not showing some volatile parameters. In our case, we will use optimization level 0. Generally, using one ELF section per function option also results in smaller executable code size. We can generate an executable code hex file by clicking on the Rebuild button. One nice trick: if we don't want to recompile all the source files, we can press function button F7 to compile only the source files that have been changed, to reduce the overall build time. Upon completion, the system reports that the build process is completed without errors, and that a hex file has been created. Before moving on, there are two files that are worth mentioning. First, STM32F10X hardware driver lib.c. This file contains main driver source code for the hardware. Second, modelfile.c. In our case, this is non-FIO_PWM_demo.c. This file contains source code for main algorithms modeled in Simulink. For example, this is the code that toggle the two output pins of the MCU. We can simulate the source code using MicroVision Debugger. Click on the Debugger button. While simulating, we will use the logic analyzer to visualize states of the output pins. So click on the logic analyzer button. Set up the logic analyzer by including port 8.3 and port 8.2 for GPIOA pin 3 and GPIOA pin 2 respectively. Virtual Simulation Register VT regs that can be monitored are listed under Symbol Window View. This window can be brought up from the View menu. The exact names of registers that can be monitored are listed in the Virtual Regs window. Port A is listed here. Start the simulation by clicking on the Run button or press F5. Use the Zoom, In, Out, or All buttons to change the view of the logic analyzer. States of port A3 and A2 are shown in the logic analyzer. Use Reset, Run, and Stop buttons to control the simulation process. The simulation time is shown in the status bar. Next, we will program our target with the executable code. This section will show you how to load the executable code to the target using STMicroelectronics Flash Loader Demo. Warning: using Flash Loader Demo to download code to your FIO boards will destroy the native Rapid STM32 bootloader. This will void any warranty on the FIO boards, which have been preloaded with such bootloader. This FIO STD board has not yet been flashed with the native Rapid STM32 bootloader. It is used for demonstration purpose only. First, we must configure our target to start booting from system memory. This will allow STMicroelectronics bootloader to run to reprogram the flash memory by using USART1. This can be achieved by setting pin boot 1 to logic low and pin boot 0 to logic high. We must also make sure that one of the serial COM port of the host PC is connected to our target USART1 port. In this picture, you may notice that we have already connected pin A3 and A2 to an oscilloscope channels 1 and 2 respectively. Having successfully configured the target, we can proceed to running the Flash Loader Demo program on the host PC. Launch the Flash Loader Demo. Select the correct COM port and other settings. Then, click Next to proceed. On this page, select Download to Device, and browse for our executable code for the target. In our case, this is non-FIOPWMDemo.hex. You may select Global Erase too. This is not compulsory. Click Next to download the executable code to the target. We can run the target by setting it to boot from main flash memory. By setting pin boot 0 to logic low and restart the target. Setting on pin boot 1 is irrelevant. This picture captures our oscilloscope screen. We can see that the target generates correct signals on both pins A3 and A2. This is the end of this training video. Thanks for watching.